Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to set up and run Next.js in Visual Studio Code. So let's get started. So for this, first I will be showing you how to download and install Visual Studio Code, then we need to install Node.js, and finally we can run Next.js. So let's get started. First thing, just Google Node.js, you'll be getting the official download link over here. Just click it. And here we can choose Node.js version. This is the latest version, version 22. And if you click this drop down, you'll be able to see the older version of Node.js. Just leave the rest to the default options. And if you scroll down, we'll be having the MSI installer as well as the zip file. Just click on this Windows installer and the download will be getting started. It is about 29 MB in size, so just be patient till then. Once the download is complete, just open it and you'll be getting the Node.js setup. Click on next and select I accept, next, and this is going to be the default location. If you want to change it, you can just click on the change button. So after selecting the destination, just click on next, and these are fine. Click on next and click on next here again and select install. The installation process will begin now. Yeah, the installation is done. Click on finish. Now if you go to your command prompt and run the command node space hyphen hyphen version, we'll be getting the node version 22, and also run the command npm hyphen hyphen version, we'll be getting the npm version also. And if you just type node and hit enter, you'll be getting the node shell. So we can just go here and type 3 plus 4, we'll be getting the output. Just Google Visual Studio Code and click on the first link, and here you will be having the option for download for Windows. Click here and the download will be getting started. It is about 103 MB in size, so just be patient till the download gets completed. So once the download is complete, just open it and we'll be getting the setup. Just click on I accept, you can just read it through. Click on next, and this is going to be the destination folder where Visual Studio Code is going to get installed. If you want to change it, you can just click on browse and change it. And once you have changed it, just click on next, and this is fine. Click on next, and also make sure that you are checking this create a desktop icon and check these two also. So by this way, you'll be able to directly right click on a folder and open it by using Visual Studio Code. So it's a good feature. You can just check everything and click on next, and yeah, this is the destination location and every other things that we configured earlier. Click on install. So once the installation is complete, just check this and click on finish. So you'll be getting an interface like this. So now let me show you how you can run a simple HTML file over here. So you can just click on this explorer icon and we'll be having this open folder. So click here and just go to the desired location and open a folder. So I'll just go here and create a new folder like this. Put HTML demo, and you can just click here, select that folder and click select folder. So now automatically we will be having this, and you can just click on yes, I trust the authors. So we are having that folder, but there is no content inside it. So we can just click on this new file and go with the new dot HTML. Alright, so here we can type our HTML code, but the font size is so small, right? So we can just click on this manage, and here we will be having the settings option. Click here, and this is the font size. You can just change this to like 35 or something, I guess. Yeah, that's pretty good. And to get the default boilerplate code in Visual Studio Code, you can just run the exclamatory mark for HTML. So just run this, and as you can see, we are having the emmet abbreviation. Hit on that, so we are getting the default boilerplate code. So I'll just go with some content in the body tag and save it. So there's a simpler way how you can run this. You can just go to extensions, and this is the place where we'll be having all the, you know, extensions. If you are using Python, you can use it. C++, everything is there. In case we want to add AI assistant, you can just install GitHub Copilot too. So for HTML, you can just search for live, and you'll be having the live server. Just install and select trust publisher and install, and just look at the download count. So that's amazing. So once it is done, if you go to my HTML code and close this, here we will be having the go live option. So if you click this directly, we will be getting the output and we can just save and view the output rather than going to the location of this and reopening our HTML file. Just click on go live. So now as you can see, this is the output that we are getting, hello world, and this directly comes from this body tag over here. So now that we have installed both Node.js as well as Visual Studio Code, just go to your desired folder and create a new folder, and let me just name it as next project, something like this, and you can simply right click and open with Visual Studio Code and just select yes I trust the authors. So now just Google Next.js, you'll be getting the first link from Vercel. Click it and select get started, and here you will be having the installation option. Select it, and if you scroll down, as you can see, we need Node.js version above 18, and here we are having the command to create our Next.js project. Copy this and open terminal and just paste it and hit enter, and you'll be getting an option OK to proceed. So you can just select the Y and hit enter, and we'll be getting the exact same options that it shows in the documentation. Basically, what's our project name, whether we will be using TypeScript or not, ESLint, Tailwind CSS and other stuff. So this depends totally up to you how you want to configure your application. So let me just go with my app, the default one, hit enter. Would you like to use TypeScript? I don't want to use TypeScript. If you want to like use it, you can use the arrow keys and toggle between no and yes. And once you're done selecting the option, hit enter. I would love to use ESLint, yes and enter. I don't want to use Tailwind CSS. Inside, I will just go with yes for this. I'll go with yes. Yes for this also. Would you like to customize import alias? I will just go with yes. I will just go with hit enter. Yeah. So now this will basically install React, React DOM and Next as dependencies along with ESLint as dev dependencies. So this will take some time. Just be patient till then. So once all the necessary packages are installed without any errors, you'll be getting this success, and it has created the project name my app. And as you can see inside our folder, now we have an entire project structure, and inside source only we will be having the main coding files, and the .json are just the config files to run and build our application. And in the documentation inside package.json for next dev, which means like start the development server in local, build is for building the application for production, next start starts a production server, and next lint runs ESLint. So now to start the application, we are currently one folder behind because next project is the folder that we created, and within that Next.js automatically created the my app project. So first thing, we need to move into this particular my app directory. So for that, use the cd command in the terminal, cd space my hyphen app, hit enter, and now we are inside this folder. Now we can just run the command npm run dev. So after running it, you'll be having this starting option, and once everything is good, you'll be having this ready option with a time. And here we will be having two links. First one is the local link, which is where our application is going to get displayed. So if you just click on control on your keyboard and just hover your mouse, you'll be having this clickable link. Click it and it will get automatically opened in your browser like this. So this is the default project that you'll be getting. This is the default code which has been already pre-written. And what if you just wanted to like make some small changes? And here you can see, right, they have also given a guide for that. Get started by editing source app, and inside that page.js file. So go here, source app page.js. So this is the code that is being rendered. We are having the image tag here. As you can see, this gives us the Next.js logo, and here are some of the code that they are having. So what we can do is we can just go here, the main thing, footer. We can just completely like remove the main, I would say. Yeah, maybe we can just have a paragraph tag saying hello world. Yeah, and save it. So if we save it, it gets automatically recompiled. And if we go to the browser, as you can see, that code has been replaced by our hello world. And in the documentation also, you can just read it out. It's really, really useful. Like, they have given about the project structure, what each and every file does in an extremely good description, layout and pages, linking and navigating, fetching data, error handling, deploying, upgrading. So they have given like a bunch of stuff, completely knowledgeable content. You can just read it through. And that's the video, guys. I hope you would have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools, OpenAI, Gemini AI, API also. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.